Now we will see a charge of electron. Charge on electron. And this charge on electron was found by the scientist R.A. Millikan by using his Millikan oil drop experiment. He has done one experiment that we can call Millikan oil drop experiment. And he found the charge of electron is this much. Is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs, and this is the charge of electron based on his experiment. We will see what is the experiment of Millikan oil drop. We can see the experimental setup here. It contains one chamber. According to Millikan, we have one chamber, a kind of cylindrical chamber here. This chamber consisting of two electrical plates. We set up two electrical plates here. These two are the electrical plates. These two electrical plates connected externally to the high voltage battery. Again, this is a positive and this is a negative electrode. Positive plate and negative plate. And if we connect externally to the battery, this is a battery setup. And the positive plate is made with a small hole. And this hole can allow only a small drop of oil. And he has taken one atomizer to spray the oil droplets. There is one atomizer. This is called atomizer. Atomizer means which can produce small droplets. If take oil in this atomizer, if you spray it, kind of sprays you can see, it will give oil droplets with a small size, teeny drops it can be produced. And when you spray these oil drops into the chamber, and the droplets can be fall due to the gravity, the droplet can fall through this small hole. It can allow only one drop. Let us assume one drop can fall from this hole. And then to observe the movement of this oil drop, we kept one microscope here, a telescope. By using this microscope, or we can say telescope, to observe the fall of oil drop. Then here we have the gas molecules inside the chamber. And these gas molecules are ionized by applying some high energy X-rays. We passed some high energy X-rays to ionize these gas molecules. Means ionization means they will get the negative charge. And this negative charge gas, whatever the gas present in that, that particles can collide with this oil droplet and they can stick to the oil droplets. Previously, oil droplet is a chargeless particle. But after applying this high voltage X-rays, these gas particles can ionize. The negative charge can be stick to the oil droplet like this. Now, the oil droplet will become charged. There is a negative charged oil droplet. See the overall setup now. The oil droplet which is falling from the top, from higher plate to the lower plate, due to the gravity, it will move downward direction. Now, due to these X-rays, when the gas molecule ionizes, when the gas molecules collide with oil droplet, this oil droplet now acquires a negative charge. Now, simultaneously, he applied some high voltage into the chamber by externally. These two plates, electrode plates, they are connected to the high voltage battery. Then, when you apply that high voltage, due to the under the influence of this electrical field, this negatively charged particle, that is the oil droplet, it can move upward direction. Why? Because this is a positive plate and this is a negative plate. Now the oil droplet, it is carrying negative charge. Due to the gravity, it will move downward direction, one way side the force. But when you apply external electric field, then it will move upward direction. Now the movement of this oil droplet, that is a falling down or moving up, depends on what? It depends on the charge present on the oil droplet and the electrical field applied externally. That is the polarity of the external electrical field. So if the downward drag or downward motion gravity and external field, downward gravity means mg, and if this value is equal to the external electric field, that is some the charge of electron into electric field E, if both are equal in that particular case, the oil droplet can be, it cannot move either direction, it will be stationary. Same like in this experiment, Arya Munlikan, what he did, he applied the equal amount of external electric field, so which retards or which make the oil droplet stationary, and by using this formula he calculated the charge of electron. Here where m is the mass of the oil droplet, that we can calculate, g anyhow gravitational force we know, and e is whatever the external electric field we apply. What is the q? Q nothing but that is the charge of electron. This is one of the unknown factor, so this we can calculate by using this formula. And here he observed that the charge of the oil droplet is like this. It is the integral multiple of this value. So every time he observed that by applying some different electric fields or different oil droplets, he observed the value of Q is like this. It is a value of 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs, and it is a value of 3.2 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. And some 4.8 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs and so on. Means what? The charge of electron, the overall, the charge of that oil droplet is the integral multiple, something the n value into, where here what is n value? It is 1.6 to 10 power minus 19 is a constant, that is the charge of electron. So n into E, where n is the integral, that is the number of electrons present in that, and E is the charge of electron. What is the charge of electron? The charge of electron E is equals to 1.6. Anyhow, electron carries negative charge, so we can give the symbol negative, minus 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. This is the charge of electron found by the scientist Millikan. So once if you know the charge of electron, then we can calculate mass of electron immediately. Why? Because we know that according to Thomson, E by m value is what? 1.75 into 10 power 11 coulomb per kg. Now we know that what is the charge of electron, E value we know according to Millikan oil drop experiment. Then you can calculate Ma value. What is the Ma now? That is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs by this value, that is 1.75 into 10 power 11. And if you simplify this, we will get approximately 9.11 or 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. And this is the mass of electron. So like this, they calculated both the charge of electron and mass of electron. So this is mass of electron, we can write here. Mass of electron is equals to 9.11 into 10 power minus 31 kg. Here we will see the discovery of proton and neutron. Proton was discovered by the scientist Goldstein. You should remember the name. Discovered by Goldstein. So again, the experiment, he did the same experiment as in the J.J. Thomson, but a slight modification in the J.J. Thomson experiment. Again, the cathode ray discharge tube experiment. So what he did, he has taken that cathode ray discharge tube. And he did a small modification here. Instead of a normal cathode, he has taken now perforated cathode. Perforated cathode means which has some holes. This is a perforated cathode. This is electrode plate positive. Sorry, cathode negative plate. And anode. Both are connected again externally through a battery. Then this is a vacuum creator. Now if you apply high voltage, in this case you observed that now he coated the phosphorescent material now at the side of cathode material, this side. This is a fluorescent material or phosphorescent material, zinc sulfide screen. Then he observed that some of the rays are, they are moving from anode to cathode side. He observed that the movement of the particles from anode to cathode side, and they are passing through these holes. These are called kind of canals, and when they hit on the phosphorescent screen, and he observed the glow. And here the rays are moving through these kind of canals, perforated at that holes, and hence these rays are called canal rays. He gave the name as canal rays. And these canal rays, they can carry the positive charge. They can carry positive charge. Why? Because they are moving from positive plate to the negative plate. When they will move towards the negative plates, if they have the positive charge, then only they can move towards the negative plate. So actually what happens here, if you see, originally, this glass tube, it contains gas molecules, that we know. Right? It contains the gas molecules. When you apply high voltage to this gas molecule can ionize. Ionization nothing but what? They can eject electrons. So some particle, if you ionize it, it can eject electrons. When it eject electrons, now this particle will become positive. Because removal of electron can give the cation. So now when this electron ejected from this gas particles, we know that as usual the electrons can move towards anode side. And this we called as the cathode rays that we have studied. According to Thomson experiment, after ionization, some of the rays, which rays? They are electrons only. Electrons can move towards anode side from cathode to anode ends. They are called cathode rays. Simultaneously, so when the gas particles ionizes to balance the charge, if electrons comes out, ultimately this dot particle, this is a gas particle, should get the positive charge. These are also rays, some charged particles. Now these positive rays, they can move towards cathode side. Why? Because they can be attracted by the negative plate. And this only he observed, that these positive particles are moving towards the cathode plate. But here he has taken this perforated and some canals, and they are called canal rays name. But they are having positive charge only. But one important point we should keep in mind here, the nature of these canal rays, there depends on the nature of the gas used here. But previous case, the cathode rays, they are having independent on the nature. Whatever the gas we take, for example, if you take hydrogen, or if you take oxygen, if you take some nitrogen, doesn't matter. Hydrogen also evolve electron, oxygen also emits electron, nitrogen also emit electron. Whatever it is, whether it is a hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, doesn't matter, all electrons are same in nature only. That is why the nature of the cathode rays, it independent on the nature of the gas. But canal rays. If, for example, electron is emitted from hydrogen, then hydrogen will get positive charge. The smallest, lightest particle, that is the canal ray, this is called proton simply. And oxygen, it carries positive charge. And nitrogen, it carries positive charge. Now, is this, means here, hydrogen plus, O plus, N plus, are they same? They are not same. Anyhow, electrons are same. Whether it coming from hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, doesn't matter. But positive rays, the canal rays are not same. Why? Because here canal rays due to the H plus ion, here canal rays due to the O plus ion, here canal rays due to the N plus ion. So here the nature of canal rays is depends on the nature of the gas taken. So these are not the constituent particles for an atom. So these electrons are the fundamental particles, constituent particles. And proton, proton is the lightest particle, so that H plus, which is coming, if hydrogen releases one electron, that we can call proton. And that we can see the fundamental particle. So like this, he done the experiment, just reverse to the J.J. Thomson experiment. Here 1 to 5, again the properties are again the same like cathode rays, they can move in a straight line pathway. In presence of external magnetic or electric field, they can undergo deflection. Why? Because they are carrying the positive charge. They can move towards the negative electrode plate. If you apply external electric field, everything. All they are having kinetic energy. All properties are similar to the cathode rays only. Only one difference is they are depends on the nature of the gas. That point you should keep in mind. Let us write here. Here, the nature of canal rays are simply positively charged particles. It depends upon nature of the gas. Used in discharge tube. One important point here. The smallest and lightest particle let us do positive ion. Instead of particle, let us take positive ion. Was obtained from hydrogen. If you use hydrogen gas, I will get the smallest and lightest positive ion from hydrogen. And it was called proton. That means H plus. So this is called proton. Again, same here, the charge to mass ratio of proton. E by M. E nothing but here charge, not electron here. Charge of proton. Let me take E of proton by mass of proton. They observed 9.58 into 10 power 7 coulomb per kg. This is the charge to mass ratio of proton. Again, the charge of the particle is almost same, whether it is electron or proton. The charge of proton, magnitude of charge of proton is equal to the magnitude of electron, but it is a positive. There is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. this is the charge of proton. So from this they calculated mass of proton. Once if you know the charge of proton, then mass of proton we can calculate. If you substitute this value here, you will get mass of proton is 1.675 approximately, 673. You can take 67 or 1.6 or 1.673 into 10 power minus 27 kg. These are the values, charge of proton and mass of proton. What is a proton? It is the lightest and the smallest positive ion. So, last, discovery of neutron. Neutron was discovered by James Chadwick. They observed by bombardment of alpha particle, that is a helium particle, to the beryllium, and he found the production of the neutron. Neutron was discovered by James Chadwick. How just he bombarded the beryllium particle, or beryllium or boron, the mass number 9, atomic number 4. If you bombard with helium particle, helium mass number 4, atomic number 2, it will form carbon, and apart from that it will produce one neutral particle. So here no atomic number, it has mass number 1, and this neutral particle is called neutron. It is a chargeless particle. They observed the chargeless particle, and mass of neutron was found like this. It is almost equal to the mass of proton. Mass of neutron equal to 1.675 into 10 power minus 27 kg. This is the mass of neutron. Almost equal to the mass of proton. That's it. This is the discovery of electron, proton, and neutrons.